पॉटी ट्रेनिंग अ चाइल्ड इज समथिंग एवरी मदर वरीज अबाउट। कुछ माएँ लकी होती हैं, उनके बच्चे अपने आप पॉटी ट्रेन हो जाते हैं, और कुछ ऐसी होती हैं जो लगी रहती हैं 3 साल 4 साल तक ट्राइंग टू पॉटी ट्रेन देयर किड्स। वेल, आई एम अ मदर ऑफ टू एंड बोथ माई किड्स वर पॉटी ट्रेन बाय द टाइम दे वर 1 year old, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर हाउ आई डिड इट एंड रियली सिंसियरली होप दैट इट विल हेल्प एट लीस्ट सम ऑफ यू। हाई गाइज, माई नेम इज छवि मित्तल एंड वेलकम टू माई स्पेस बींग वुमन विद छवि। तो सबसे पहला सवाल ये है कि पॉटी ट्रेनिंग की शुरुआत कब की जाए। आई थिंक द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट इज दैट यू एज अ मदर शुड बी रेडी, एंड वेन एवर यू फील दैट योर चाइल्ड इज नाउ रेडी टू बी पॉटी ट्रेन्ड, दैट इज द परफेक्ट टाइम। आई टेल यू व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड विद हरम, आई स्टार्टेड व्हेन ही वॉज 3 months प्लस, और मैंने थोड़ी जल्दी शुरुआत की। उसके कई रीजन्स थे, एक तो ये कि आई हैडन्ट रिज्यूम्ड फुल टाइम ऑफिस एट दैट टाइम, सो आई वॉज मोर लेस होम and I wasn't sure if 6 months down the line the scenario is going to be the same or not, if 1 year down the line is going to be the same or not. And when you're potty training your child, it is important that you're with the child all the time so that you can read all the signs that your child is giving you regarding his potty and his susu. So that was one reason. Second reason was that I feel good habits jitni jaldi inculcate ki jaye utna acha hai, kyunki today or tomorrow you have to potty train your child, right? It is always better to do that before he starts school, because school mein jaakar bahut sare aur log hote hain jo aapke bacche ko handle kar sakte hain, right? Also, I know some kids who get so used to pooping in the diaper that even at the age of 3-4 they prefer pooping in a diaper rather than the bathroom. So that is something that I did not want to experience with my kids, and hence I started potty training both my kids after they crossed 3 months, and when they had good head support, when their spine was strong enough, that's when I started. How did I actually start potty training Arham when he was only 3 months old? Well, तो बहुत ही simple था। मैंने क्या किया कि जब भी मैं उसे feed करती थी, मैं realize करती थी कि कभी कभी वो बीच में fuss करने लगता था, और कभी कभी वो सडनली फीड करना बंद हो जाता था। ही यूज टू गेट क्रैंकी एंड देन आई यूज टू स्मेल द पू। सो आई अंडरस्टूड दैट व्हेन दिस इज द पैटर्न इन हिज बिहेवियर, दैट इज द टाइम दैट ही इज पूपिंग। सो एवरी टाइम दैट आई रियलाइज्ड ही इज स्टार्टिंग टू पूप इन हिज डाइपर, ऑल आई डिड वॉज मैं उसे जेंटली ऐसे अपनी गोद में बिठाती थी विद हिज बैक सपोर्टेड अगेंस्ट माई चेस्ट, एंड आई यूज टू होल्ड हिज नीज इन अ स्क्वाटिंग पोजिशन। तो वो उस पोजिशन में बैठ कर पूप करता था, और धीरे धीरे इन अ फ्यू मंथ्स टाइम ही गॉट यूज टू पूपिंग इन दैट पोजिशन, एंड स्लोली आई रियलाइज दैट ही स्टार्टेड आस्किंग मी टू एक्चुअली होल्ड हिम इन दैट पोजिशन, बिकॉज यूज टू गेट वेरी अनकम्फर्टेबल पूपिंग लाइंग डाउन। और जैसे ही वो थोड़ा बैठने लगा अपने आप, एंड आई न्यू दैट हिज स्पाइन इज परफेक्टली इन गुड कंट्रोल नाउ, आई स्टार्टेड टेकिंग हिम टू द पॉट at that time. So जब भी मुझे लगता था now he's going to poop, I would put the baby pot seat on the pot and I would hold him gently, make him sit on the pot and he would poop in the pot. So उससे फ़ायदा क्या हुआ, that थोड़ा मेरे लिए tedious था उस time पर, because कई बार दिन में 4-4 बार मैं उसको लू लेके जाती थी, आधा आधा घंटा उसको पकड़ के बैठती थी, but कुछ होता नहीं था, you know, 4 times में से 1 या 2 बार he used to make a big poop, but I think in the long run, इससे फ़ायदा मुझे ये हुआ कि by the time Arham was 8 months, 9 months, I think 10 months, he had completely stopped pooping in his diaper, and he would always start crying and he would make that face sitting on the chair and asking me to take him to the loo, and he would not start pooping till I took him to the loo. Susu training is a bit tricky. But again, with Arham and Areeza both, I started really, really early. And I remember that I used to take Arham to the loo to pee, I think when he was just about 3 months. मैं उसे लेके जाती थी वॉश बेसन पे, स्क्वाटिंग पोजिशन में बिठाती थी, and I used to make that sound and he would pee. And then I had timed his pee schedule. And you'll realize, आपके बेबी के साथ भी हर बेबी का अपना एक शेड्यूल होता है when the baby pees after the feed. This was Arham's routine. After a feed, he would pee 10 minutes later, then 20 minutes later again, then 30 minutes later again. तो वो थोड़ा सा घड़ी का हिसाब रख के मैं उसे बाथरूम में लेकर जाती थी where he used to pee. But इससे mostly, I don't think Arham understood much about it at that time. But इससे फ़ायदा ये हुआ that he started associating the bathroom with potty and susu. And then I realized when he started sitting down around at around 6 months, वो मुझे बहुत डायरेक्ट सिग्नल्स देता था दैट नाउ आई वांट टू पी और नाउ मामा वार्निंग आई एम गोइंग टू पी नाउ एंड दीज टू सिग्नल्स वर एक तो ही वुड टच हिमसेल्फ बिकॉज आई थिंक ही फेल्ट दैट ओके समथिंग इज हैपनिंग राइट नाउ सो ही वुड टच हिमसेल्फ एंड आई वुड क्विकली पिक हिम अप टेक हिम टू द लू एंड मेक हिम पी सेकेंड सिग्नल दैट ही यूज्ड टू गिव मी वॉज क्रॉल करते करते सडनली वो रुक जाता था एंड यूज्ड टू जस्ट स्टेयर एट समथिंग क्वाइटली और लुक एट मी and just stay there in that position for 5-10 seconds and I knew that right now he's peeing. So every time that would happen, again, I would pick him up, take him to the loo. And thankfully, now at 14 months of age, he actually has started speaking a few words and Susu is one of them. So whenever he wants to pee, he says, Mama, pee too. Night diapers is something that I want to talk about now. Aram is 14 months old, but he's still wearing diapers in the night and for every nap. The reason for this is, main believe karti hoon ki ek bacche ki uninterrupted sleep jo hai, wo bahut zyada important hai. It is more important than potty training or susu training because, especially nighttime sleep. Because raat ko jab, when the baby sleeps for more than 8 hours at a stretch, that is the time he's growing. His body is recovering and all the food and the nutrition that he's taken during the day is getting absorbed by the body and you know all those things are happening in the night. So it's important for the child to have uninterrupted sleep. Isliye at 14 months also I prefer to make him wear a diaper in the night. Now with Ariza also I did the same but I started removing her night diapers after she turned 2 years old. I'll give you 2 tips regarding this. One is a tip that I got from her doctor, her pediatrician, who told me that once your child goes for 5 hours without peeing, yani ki between 2 susus, there's 5 hours of gap, it means that your child is ready to get out of night diapers. And the second thing in Ariza's case was that she had started talking at 2. So every time she wanted to pee in the night, she would actually wake me up and say, Mama, susu. You know, it was just as simple as that. And also there were many times that there were accidents in the night when she wouldn't wake up and, you know, there would be an accident in the night. Then I would go and change the entire bed sheet. I would change her clothes. I would wash her. And then again, I would put her back to sleep. But I think that was an experience which also made her realize that if I pee in bed, then I'll have to go through all of this before I can actually go back to bed again, you know, go back to sleep again. So it's a learning process. It's a process of growing up for the child also. And these are small, small things from which the child also learns and the parent also learns. But I think by the time Ariza was 2.5 years old, she was fully out of diapers even in the night. And I completely intend to do the same for Arham. I decided to potty train both my kids really early. There are mothers who decide to do it later in life. And I think it's completely a mother's choice. But only thing that I would like to add here is that whenever you decide to go down that road, make sure that you follow it through. Don't give interruptions. Don't break the routine in the middle because that sort of really confuses the child. And having said that, whether you decide to do it early, whether you decide to do it late, there are no judgments. We are all mothers here trying to help out each other. And I really hope that my experience helped you. And I would love to hear your feedback and your thoughts on potty training in the comments down below. Please write something and share your opinion with me. And also don't forget to give me a like. Share this video with any mother who's struggling with potty training. And please don't forget to subscribe to Being Woman with Chavi. This is me signing out. Love and peace from me to you.